By the time of Breath of the Wild, Ganon has seemingly decayed into a feral beast, a force of nature that attacks Hyrule in a blind fury. The sequel, however, appears to be exploring the human origins of the Calamity, and the connection between the monster and the man he once was. Because Ganon was once human, a powerful Gerudo leader who led his people to war against Hyrule. But in truth, the Gerudo had been ruled in secret by another, older evil for centuries. The twin witches, Kotake and Koume, controlled their tribe from the shadows, using magic to extend their lives well beyond what was natural. Apart, they were the Sorceress of Ice and the Sorceress of Flame, but together they formed Twin Rover, a powerful being with mastery over both elements. The pair are guilty of countless terrible acts, but one stands out above the rest. The twins raised Ganondorf as his surrogate mothers. Today, let's look at the history and lore of Kotake and Koume, the Gerudo witches. The origins of the witches is a mystery, but we do know that they were born around 400 years before the events of Ocarina of Time. They're Gerudo, they belong to a tribe of powerful warrior women to whom a male is born only once every century, a man who will become their king. In the years before Ocarina of Time, Hyrule was swallowed by a war that lasted an age, known as the Hyrulean Civil War. Little is known for certain about this war, except that the Gerudo and the Hylians were on opposite sides, and the conflict finally ended with Ganondorf swearing fealty to the king, placing the Gerudo Desert under his control. The war was violent and bloody, evidenced by the Shadow Temple and the atrocities committed there by the Sheikah. Hyrule Historia states that this war lasted for countless eras, and Ganondorf was still young when he surrendered to the king, which suggests that the fighting between the Gerudo and the royal family went on for years before Ganon's birth, which means that the origin of Twin Rover is clouded by war. Much of the twins' 400-year lives were during this conflict, and we can assume that many of them were spent secretly governing the Gerudo tribe from afar, and that they had a greater influence on the war than almost anyone else. As the covert leaders of the tribe, it's no surprise that when Ganondorf was born, the child was theirs to raise. It's unlikely that the pair are in any way related to Ganondorf, neither are his biological mother, they just raised him as their future leader. By the time of the events of Ocarina of Time, Kotake and Koume are ancient, shriveled figures, their lives artificially prolonged by magic. The Hyrulean Civil War has ended, with the Gerudo Desert now under the control of the king, and Hyrule unified under one banner. Much of the Gerudo tribe now follow Ganondorf and worship him like a god. But not all. Noboru, the Gerudo second-in-command, hates her king. She explains that while she and her followers are thieves, they believe Ganondorf has gone too far. He steals from women and children, and murders without second thought. The Gerudo King was operating out of the Spirit Temple, using it as a base for him and his followers, which included Kotake and Koume. Noboru plotted to sneak into the Spirit Temple, to steal treasure and to interfere with Ganondorf's plans. She intends to steal the silver gauntlets, which would allow her to access the deeper parts of the temple, but is ambushed by the witches, who imprison her with black magic. Around the same time as this, Ganondorf pledges his loyalty to the royal family, but in secret he attempts to extort the spiritual stones from Hyrule's various races by poisoning gods and cutting off food sources. He eventually manipulates Link, the young child of a woman who fled the fires of war, into collecting these sacred stones and opening the Door of Time. While Link himself was sealed for 7 years within the Chamber of Sages, Ganondorf broke into the Sacred Realm and laid his hands on the Triforce. For one with a balanced heart, this would have been enough to take control of the artifact, but Ganondorf's heart was impure, and the Triforce shattered, leaving him with only the piece that he represented best, the Triforce of Power. Still, this was an unimaginably powerful tool, with which the Gerudo King brought Hyrule to its knees. For years, the kingdom burned. Castletown was reduced to ashes, and its people fled to seek refuge elsewhere. But in the 7th year of Ganondorf's reign, hope returns to Hyrule. Link was released from the Sacred Realm, now fit to wield the legendary Master Sword and wear the title of Hero of Time. The boy from the forest journeys across Hyrule, freeing the land's temples from Ganondorf's evil influence, and helping the six sages to awaken and fulfill their sacred duties. This means that the hero eventually travels to the Gerudo Desert, to the Desert Colossus and the Spirit Temple. By jumping back through time, Link, as a child, helps Noboru steal the silver gauntlets to break into the Spirit Temple. But the warrior is captured by Kotake and Koume, and she remains in captivity for 7 years. During this time, Noboru is brainwashed by the witches and forced to serve Ganondorf against her will. While bewitched, she and a gang of thieves terrorize Hyrule, using cruelty and brutality to get their way. Noboru even experimented with brainwashing people herself, acting nothing like the woman she once was, instead as Twin Rover's puppet. This torment continued until Link returned to the Spirit Temple as an adult, 7 years after he met Noboru there as a child. He battles his way through the Gerudo Shrine until he comes face to face with the witches, who pore over a peculiar iron knuckle sat on a throne. The pair are insulted by Link's intrusion into their temple, and decide to show him a lesson by releasing the iron knuckle on the hero. Link fights the armored warrior, the clash of steel ringing through the ancient stone halls, until finally the Master Sword shatters the thick plate and the iron knuckle falls to the ground. The armor crumbles away, revealing not a monster, but Noboru, her mind finally her own after 7 years of brainwashing. The Gerudo commander comes to her senses, free from her iron cage, but is ambushed yet again by Kotake and Koume, who plan to bewitch her once more. But this time, Noboru isn't alone. The witches retreat into an ornate chamber, followed closely by Link. Kotake and Koume are impressed with his tenacity, joking that he's come to offer himself as a personal sacrifice to the great Ganondorf. The pair ready themselves for battle. Kotake is the Sorceress of Flame and Koume of Ice. Using their mastery of the elements, the twins battle Link with magic, but the hero bounces back their spells with the Mirror Shield, a legendary Gerudo artifact. Even combining into a single being, their double dynamite attack isn't enough to stop the hero, who again uses their own powerful magic against them. And so, after 4 centuries, the lives of Twin Rover come to an end. Strangely for such evil beings, the twins find halos above their heads, and bicker amongst themselves as they ascend to the heavens. This marks the end of Kotake and Koume. Noboru was freed by Link and awakened as the Sage of Spirit, and the great King of Evil Ganondorf was brought to his knees and sealed in a nameless void. But this isn't the only ending of Ocarina of Time. It of course splits the timeline, resulting in 3 separate branches of history. In the timeline following Ganondorf's defeat, we never hear from Twin Rover again. Though Ganondorf returns in the Wind Waker, the only mention of his surrogate mothers is the engravings on his twin swords. The witches remain dead, defeated by the Hero of Time. But we do see Kotake and Koume in both the Child and Downfall timelines. In the Child's timeline, caused by Link travelling back in time to before Ganondorf's betrayal and warning Princess Zelda, Link leaves Hyrule in search of Navi. He becomes trapped in Termina, a bizarre, dreamlike alternate dimension where he eventually meets Kotake and Koume, though they're not the same. Like many of Termina's citizens, they share the same faces as characters from Hyrule, but are entirely different. These witches run potion shops and cruises, and are kind and friendly, the exact opposite of their Hyrulean counterparts. Nothing is known about the history of these alternate counterparts of Twin Rover, but they're almost certainly completely different people to the witches who raised Ganondorf. However, as the Child timeline follows the course of history after Link prevents much of Ocarina of Time from happening, this means that Twin Rover were never killed by the hero in the Spirit Temple, and they remain as secret leaders of the Gerudo. The events in Hyrule between Ocarina of Time and Twilight Princess are vague, and we're not given many details to work with. What's clear is that with the information given to her by the time-traveling Link, Princess Zelda decided to act, preventing Ganondorf's betrayal and his entry into the Sacred Realm. Many years later, this leads to his attempted execution. Clearly, some conflict occurred between the Hylians and Ganondorf. The Gerudo tribe are notably absent from Twilight Princess's Hyrule, only returning later on in the timeline in Four Swords Adventures, but it's entirely possible that Kotake and Koume lived on well into the Child timeline, continuing to control their people from the shadows. This takes us then to the Downfall timeline, an alternate version of history in which Link falls to Ganondorf at the climax of Ocarina of Time, forcing the sages to imprison him within the Sacred Realm along with the entire Triforce. We know that all seven sages sealed Ganon, meaning that by the time Link was killed, he had already saved Noboru and killed Twin Rover. But at some point during the long years of the Downfall timeline, the witches returned, resurrected by some unknown power. Though their master had been slain by a hero during A Link to the Past, this didn't dampen their loyalty, and the pair hatched a plot to resurrect him. Kotake and Koume summoned two powerful demons from the Dark Realm, the dragon Onox and the evil fairy Veram, to terrorize the neighboring lands of Labrinna and Holodrum. Under the orders of Twin Rover, General Onox captures Din, the Oracle of Seasons, and disrupts the flow of the seasons in Holodrum. And Veran possesses Nehru, the Oracle of Ages, and uses her abilities to travel back through time and cause chaos. The damage done by these demons is enough to light the flames of sorrow and of destruction, two parts of a trifecta of sacred flames capable of reviving Ganon. The third flame, the Flame of Despair, requires a sacrifice to light, and so the witches kidnap Princess Zelda, planning to use her life to resurrect their master. This would have happened were it not for Link, who arrived just in time to interrupt the ceremony. Kotake and Koume decide to put a stop to the hero themselves, first fighting him as a duo, and then, just like before, by combining into a single body. Twin Rover again uses both fire and ice as weapons, either freezing the sacrificial chamber or causing it to erupt into a volcanic pit, but is eventually defeated with a mystery seed. Link had managed to stop the witches from sacrificing Zelda, but not from completing their ritual. Instead, Twin Rover gives up its own body, using itself as the vessel for the resurrection ceremony in place of the princess. What little energy the pair had left is extinguished, and their physical body is destroyed, but they succeed. Ganon lives once more. Except, not all of Ganon returned. By sacrificing themselves instead of Princess Zelda, Twin Rover had failed to fully resurrect their master. The Gerudo King they raised centuries ago was incredibly cunning and manipulative, as intellectually powerful as he was physically. Even after obtaining the Triforce and becoming a monstrous boar demon, Ganon was still intelligent enough to usurp the King of Hyrule by using an alter ego to take control of the kingdom, all while imprisoned in the Dark World. The Ganon that was revived by Twin Rover's sacrifice towered over Link, wielding his mighty trident and mastery of magic. Physically, he had returned, but his mind was lost. The Demon King is barely able to string together a sentence, and lacks any plan other than total destruction. Though powerful, Ganon was swiftly defeated by Link, and Twin Rover's work was undone. Chronologically, the Oracle Games are the latest appearance of Kotake and Koume, a final attempt to continue the work they began centuries earlier in Ocarina of Time. Though they remained in the shadows for much of Hyrule's history, the pair have had an incredibly strong influence on the kingdom, from their involvement in the Hyrulean Civil War to raising the Gerudo King Ganondorf. We never get a look at the backstory of these characters. The motivations behind their actions are entirely unknown. Twin Rover are sadistic and devious, traits they instilled in the man they raised. Ganondorf's descent into madness was a fate sealed thousands of years earlier as the result of an ancient curse, but the women who raised him are perhaps just as guilty. His burning lust for the Triforce and his desire for conquest were likely inherited from demise, but his cruel cunning and his talent for manipulation mirror his adoptive parents. Ironically, though, for those who were responsible for helping shape Ganondorf's calculating mind, their actions may have destroyed it. Following the oracles in the Downfall timeline, we never again see the cunning Ganon of A Link to the Past or Ocarina of Time. He's closer to a mindless, rampaging beast. It's entirely possible that this was because of Twin Rover's botched resurrection, resulting in Ganon becoming a creature of purely physical and magical power, incapable of complex schemes. Kotake and Koume were Ganondorf's surrogate mothers, but they might have played as big a part in the fall of Ganon as they did his rise to power. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, leave a like or subscribe if you haven't already for more Zelda content. Cheers guys, and I'll see you next time.